Captain Phantom's day begins when the company's bus collects him from his home in Blenheim and he joins the aircrew for the short trip to the airport. Safe Air has 11 Bristol freighters flying between Blenheim, Wellington and Nelson. They carry some 1,000 tonnes per week. It's one of the world's largest airlifts. Two shifts of 8 hours each day, with a return flight each 75 minutes, keep this small operations room busy. Pilots are briefed, weather forecasts received, cargo loads checked, and though Captain Phantom has crossed Cook Strait at least 10,000 times, this latest flight with First Officer Lyford is still preceded by the same careful routine as the first. The same careful engineers inspections between flights as the Bristol swallows another 5.5 tons of cargo. All engine and airframe maintenance are carried out in the company's workshops, but now there's just time to check fuel tanks and oil levels before the crew go aboard. Captain Phantom has 14,000 flying hours on his logbook, dating back to Catalinas in World War II, before even the Vampire was designed. The mechanical loader, designed by New Zealand Railways, can unload and load the aircraft in under 10 minutes. This successful design has been adopted by the world's great carriers, including the US Air Force. But it's time for takeoff. All doors and hatches closed, ignition on, propellers clear. George, a ground engineer, gives the thumbs up sign. Then the starboard motor turns and 22 tons of aircraft and load is underway. Captain Phantom, in radio touch with the tower, is given permission to taxi to the vicinity of the runway and carry out his pre-takeoff check procedures, whilst Bristol BMA makes its landing. Thank you. flaps operating, gyro set, pitch levers forward, brake pressures, oil temperatures, generators, all correct. Full boost and power from each 2000 horsepower engine, and the bistro is quickly up to 83 knots and airborne. A right-hand bank, and out over Blenheim, whose citizens regard these freighters with such affection. They're friendly, not too noisy, dependable and thoughtful. The Bristol always swings away from town, lest it disturb the folks below, whose isolation has at last been terminated by air transport. Now it's time to check with Blenheim Airport. Height 2,000 feet, speed 140 knots, crossing the wire bar. Then a quick change of frequency to the Wellington control tower. Bristol Echo Oscar 2,000 feet, wire bar. Estimated time of arrival 10:50 hours Wellington. Wellington rogers out after asking that we call when reaching Sinclair Head. The trip record has to be filled in 15 minutes after each takeoff. Oil and fuel pressures, engine revs, generator readings, every system in the aircraft is held under constant surveillance in the log. There goes ZKBMA, 500 feet below, as the North Island landfall of Sinclair Head comes into view. And the Wellington Tower calls Bristol Echo Oscar, wind southeasterly, 10 knots. Ground pressure 1001.2 millibars. Friendship on runway preparing to take off. You may land on number 2 when it's airborne. Captain and first officer adjust their altimeters and down they go. Tail wheel locked, brake pressure's okay, booster pumps on, flaps down. Speed 90 knots, 85 knots, and ZKBEO is down. When its flaps up, booster pumps off, unlock the tail wheel and taxi to the loading ramp. Remember, the average time on the ground between flights is 15 minutes. Out comes the load as the aircraft is fueled up. The motors use 120 gallons per hour when cruising and 270 gallons per hour at takeoff. Captain Phantom gives the usual order of 50 gallons each side for the run to Blenheim and back. But let's vary the routine and join Captain Beatty on a tobacco run to Nelson. Taxi to the holding bay of runway 16 for cockpit checks, and Captain Beatty goes through the routine and the airfield echoes to the noise as each engine is run up to static boost for magneto tests. BNB to final approach orders the control tower. A final adjustment to the friction screws on the throttle and pitch controls, and the aircraft fills with the sound of high pressure air released from the braking system as BEO lines up on the runway. And BEO show a cleaner figure as any passenger airliner when climbing out of Wellington. Look, Vern, let's go a little lower and say hello to the Tamihini. She'll soon be gone and the Aramoana will replace her. I wonder how it will affect us. Bristol BEO at 3,000 feet, course 270 degrees off Sinclair Head. Estimated time of arrival, Nelson, 1,200 hours. The South Island coast is crossed at Port Underwood, that old haunt of whalers, but now one of Marlborough's summer resorts, as is Picton, nestling 3,000 feet below in Queen Charlotte Sound, the mecca of holidaymakers from all over New Zealand. But water skiing and boating are not the only pursuits. Below in the rich flats linking the Queen Charlotte and Pelorus Sound lie the dairy farms of Mahaki Power. Then Marlborough's other great waterway, the 30-mile-long Pelorus Sound, with the township of Havelock at the mouth of the Pelorus River, up whose fertile valley our course continues. This is a visual flight for Captain Beattie over a well-known route, over Lyle Price's woolshed and Dalton's Reach of the River, famous for its trout, to the Matai Saddle and the watershed leading down to Nelson. Flaps down, all fuel cocks and booster pumps on, brake pressure's okay, tail wheel locked, and Bristol Echo Oscar rolls down the Nelson runway. There's no mechanised 10-minute turnaround here, yet the Nelson crew can jack up the aircraft and pull out the load with a skill born of much practice, and there's barely time for a cup of tea before it's takeoff again. Pilot's day is a pleasant one. The routine's never dull. Even to an old hand like Captain Beatty, there's still a tension and excitement in flying in thick weather, in controlling the power and speed of the aircraft. On this winter afternoon, the serenity and beauty of the sounds and Cook Strait is ample reward. Off to the north lies Kapiti Island. Ahead is the usual landfall at Sinclair Head, and it's time once more to radio the Wellington Tower, with the request that Bristol Echo Oscar be allowed to make a left-hand circuit over Wellington. South Island again appears as the aircraft loses altitude. most pride themselves on their parking capabilities. Try parking from a height of 21 feet over a wheelbase of 27 feet 6 inches. It's seldom a pilot needs a second attempt to butt against the chocks. Captain Phantom's been on the Blenheim run, so let's join him for his last trip of the day. Still the same careful routine, doors and hatches and petrol caps closed, trim set, fuel cocks on, ignition on, flaps operating, gyros set, oil temperatures and pressures, generators all set, and check boost and magnetos, running up each engine to its required revs. Though Captain Phantom makes 20,000 crossings, he'll never make a careless one. The company is safe, as are the pilots. And home is a pleasant place, over the Wairau Bar, past Manu McDonald's farm, over the river where we go white baiting, over the mayor's residence. Past Cleghorn Street, where Mrs. Phantom will look up, and we salute her with a slight change of course. And the tower, as formal and concise as ever, radios Bristol Echo Oscar, wind calm, pressure 1001.3 millibars, no aircraft in the circuit, cleared to land. Captain Phantom's stint is over. Just a word to the engineer about the lock on the rear wheel. He'd better take a look at it. It's been a grand day.